The election is still 2 years away, if you can believe that, but our next guest is getting a jump on campaigning for mayor of the city of Memphis.
Most of you already know him, though, fairly well. Dedrick Golden was a star basketball player for the University of Memphis back in the late 90s and now runs a community service agency, really. You've just given back tremendously to the Greenlaw community, but why mayor, Dedrick?
Well, I love my city, and I'm kind of tired of seeing the way it's going. I think some changes need to be made. I think, first of all, we have to start with the youth. We used to say the children are our future. Now it's as if that's a cliche, and we don't really care about our youth. And you look at the numbers, 14 to 24, they're going to jail early. And I think someone needs to step in and care about the youth and let them know we care about them.
So, Dedrick, though, can one person, though, really make a difference, no matter who is at the top of City Hall? And is this a reflection on the current mayor, that perhaps you feel he's not doing the job that he could be?
Well, I don't have anything against AC. It's not really, me running for mayor is not really dealing with AC. It's just me loving my city and want to lead it in the right direction. I think we need to work on race relations also. Things divide us, the renaming of the park, for example. Issues like that, instead of thinking about the name of the park, why don't we deal with the homeless people that's in the park? Why don't we help them? I think our priorities are not where they should be. I think it takes not a politician, but a leader. Typically, politicians, they say they run for the people, but once they're elected, they run from the people.
But at the same time, yesterday, a new homeless initiative was unveiled, mm-hmm. as you may know, involving the city mayor and the county mayor. Is there something about that project you do like or don't like, or what?
Well, I actually approached AC 2 years ago. I wanted the Sears Towers building I wanted a dream center like they have in LA, a kind of one-stop shop for homeless people, felons, people needing jobs and training. I approached them about that 2 years ago. But, you know, he didn't want to hear that, and now I see why. But that's been my heart all along. I have a prison ministry, I have a homeless ministry, and I just think we need to help the marginalized people. The real decision makers in this city, they don't live in impoverished neighborhoods. They don't deal with crime, so the crime rate is not really going to go down. The school systems, I mean, the public school system is horrible right now. Kids can't read. But the decision makers, again, their kids attend private schools. So they don't deal with those issues. So we don't need a politician. We really need a leader. And I'm that leader.
With the financial situation that we face, though, you know, let me just pick one thing out that you say you're passionate about, firefighters and police officers and making mm-hmm. sure that they're taken care of. With the financial constraints we have, I mean, do you see that once in office it's maybe not as easy as from the outside looking in, well, saying we need to support them financially, but where do we get the money?
Well, I agree. It's a daunting task I have ahead of me. But if you look at some of the money that we give to people who's already well off, and I don't want to say anything.
Like, for instance? No, you probably need to give an example
The Riverside ordeal. We gave them a certain amount of money, and now they want more money. You look at the International Paper ordeal. They wanted $3 million to build a bridge there. Why can't that money go to the youth? Why can't it go back to the firefighters and the citizens? And then you look at the tax increase. Only maybe 3% going to go back to the public. The rest goes to the city government. So the money is there. It's just a matter of who's getting the money.
We have less than 30 seconds left here, Dedrick. What type of support do you have out there right now? Is this more of a grassroots effort? Or are you just slowly but surely trying to get the word out? You already have supporters out there. I know a lot of people know your name. But what type of support do you have out there?
Well, I have a lot of support. A lot of people are actually fed up with the city and this current administration. They're ready for change. They're ready for a leader, not another politician who's going to say the right thing, but once elected, do his own thing. I have support, but I do need more support. I need more financial support, and you can do that on MayorGolden.com's website, or you can call my phone number, 313-0506. I'm going to need money if I'm going to really fight this battle, because they're going to say certain things. I'm not a statesman and things like that. So I need to be able to rebut those statements. And so it's going to take money. I know that. So I do have a daunting task ahead
of me. Well, tomorrow you are officially announcing, correct?
I am. At Greenlaw Community Center, 12 o'clock noon.
All right.
I want all my Tiger fans to come out and support this ordeal.
Okay. Are you going to take on AC in a one-on-one basketball game eventually?
AC is like 70. That won't work. That would not
but
work.
But he is very fit.
As you know.
I'm a Tiger.
All right, thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.